Hello, everybody. Welcome to game number three of the fifth newcomers tournament. In this game, we have Fredward, who's sitting on two wins, Ian with one win, and I believe Dimmy also has one win, and then Status Warp still hunting for their first win. I'm Philothanic. Joining me today is Andreas G. Andreas, what do you think about this map?
Ooh, I see. If I'm a player here, I'm really looking for this Nomad spawn in particular. Look at all this high silicon, and it's basically everything there is on this map, so you can certainly find yourself in a monopoly situation where nobody can even... And here you see, indeed, Fredward taking it for quite a bit of
38k, I'd say that's worth it.
And you can't slant drill this either too easy. You just gotta make sure he also picks up this remote one. Close over. Oh no, there's another one further up. Okay, it's going to be a bit harder to get that monopoly than I first thought, but it's definitely possible.
I mean, yeah, there is only one, and nobody's really founding super close to that silicon. Dimmy's in the best spot to get into it with that expansive found right here in the middle. They won't mind that shipping distance. That shipping distance definitely not an issue for an expansive with their one-third less fuel shipping. Now let's take a look at the other founds. Let's start with Ian. What do you think about Ian's found?
Ian going scientific, and he does take advantage of this new concept ever since the Jupiter Forge, where the scientific can use his special trait where he can take resource right from the ground on ice too. So you can see him putting a greenhouse farm here on the ice. So it makes this play viable, but He's going to have a hard time because a lot of the primary resources, such as silicon, is far, far away.
Yeah, Ian.
And where can he even get aluminium from?
Ian's betting that everyone else will be able to cover those basic resources. And the only thing I don't like about Ian's found is I would have found it a little bit more to the north and sacrificed some adjacency bonus on my steel, northwest that is, so I can get more ice. Right? Because he doesn't have a lot of ice next to his base to work with. It's split up, which is good, but definitely going to be hard. Dimmy was, I believe, the second player to HQ2. That's the expansive right in the middle. They're found. I'd say that's a decent found. You're going to be shipping a decent amount, but that's kind of what expansives are built for, is right? Shipping decent distances. There are no nukes. You don't have to worry about your faraway claims being turned into useless tiles.
Going into an early geothermal too, and slow up his upgrades a little bit, but then again, it still isn't that expensive quite yet, so I guess he can tank through it.
Right, and half price steel on that geothermal plant, another one of expansive found, so one of the few HQs that I don't mind going into a HQ2 geotherm. It is goon, so that's good. And then last but not least, Status Warp. What do you think about Status is found?
He is dependent on remote shipping here, so I would be surprised if we don't see any filthy pirates right here trying to knock out. He's still, if that price goes up quite a bit, but I think he's suffering a bit from shipping here for sure, only really having the water close to him, so he too is going to have some issues. So I do see a pattern here. A lot of these players is really going to look into getting that teleportation
or water engine.
Or water engine, yeah. So I do see a situation where he might have a rush for those patterns. It's going to be interesting to follow.
So where have we seen this play before? Tell me if this sounds familiar. Fredward, HQ3, Nomad, 2 geotherms.
Yeah, I was about to point it out. However, the difference here is that we got Dimmy too, producing quite a bit of power. So I think that the price is going to tank too soon for Fredward, and that investment ain't really going to pay off.
Right, so Fredward's going to be stuck with 30k debt, unfortunately covering all of their life support debt. So that 35k that they found it on isn't going to be terribly bad. Now, we did say that Ian was going to have trouble with Ian's the one with a better scientist spot, lacking a bit in the water. But is HQ3, and everything's really close together, so EMPs, good tool.
So he gets EMP'd, yeah.
Scientists,
almost, like, fixed it.
For those coming back post-Jupiter's Forge, scientists no longer have the EMP or freeze resist. It was a trade-off for gaining the ability to pull resources straight out of ice.
Which is a fair trade-off. I think the scientific is very strong on many maps with that ability. But I guess if you are Ian at the moment, you're thinking about grabbing some more remote water here to produce primary resources later on, maybe. In which case, filthy pirates can come into play again, and then again you will probably see some attempt at grabbing teleportation.
So
I don't know if this is an
error or not. Is HQ4, and I don't think Redward has been targeted by the black market once.
The black market is online.
He's been making a lot of money off the back of glass too.
So nomads are, in my opinion, the strongest faction in Offworld Trading Company right now, and in part is because it's so easy to run into a really large lead like this. Now, it's other players need to recognize that nomads are dangerous. So you need to hit them with black market when they start going through these really fast upgrades. Check and see who's been buying all of the claims. Ian with 2, Fredward 1, Dimmy 1.
Yes, it's evenly spread out, more or less.
Let the bidding begin.
So those claims are good, but you need to make sure that the nomad doesn't get in such a lead that you can't, you know, use those claims in the late game, right?
Yeah, that's a good point.
Everyone else is on HQ3 now, only one HQ behind.
And they don't really have a lot of cash at hand either. Fredward is one with 20k available to him, and is also the most ranked up one, say. Or upgraded one. But then again, you do have Expansive, you're too scientific, this is late game faction, so if they can resist this from Fredward, they might find themselves in a prime position later on.
Right. The one thing I'd say that Fredward needs to do is there are claims on the black market. You got one, now you have 2. Make sure you continue to buy into those claims while they're cheap. Then you can compete with the scientist in the Expansive late game.
Mm-hmm.
And then it won't matter. So the other players just need to slow down Fredward enough with the black market, which is not happening. Fredward first HQ5 when 2 other players are in HQ3.
Status did froze out quite a bit of it, but it's still a bit late, him already being in HQ5.
Yeah. I mean, better late than never, right? But would have been strictly better when Fredward was on HQ4, HQ3.
Still a ridiculously cheap EMP for stasis right there, so definitely paying off. I really like it.
About to see.
Oh, I want to check how this scientific people does here, because I was always a bit curious to how they would solve it.
Solve what?
All the distance shipping here.
Yeah,
so
well,
stasis seems to be doing fine, I guess. Same with Ian.
Ian's solution is ignore it and just go straight into life support.
Yeah. It might be a trouble late game thing.
Yeah, it could be. Now we'll have to see.
HQ has been upgraded.
Dimmy. Okay, what's going on with Dimmy right now? Dimmy has 8.4k for the upgrade. They're in some electrolysis reactors, which are making okay money. They're moving into a single electronics farm, single greenhouse farm, single glass kiln. Those need to be in pairs, right? 2 greenhouse farms would be making 60, 70 something a second versus your 47 and 36 single tiles. So I really want to see those gain some pairs for that adjacency bonus when Dimmy gets the upgrade to HQ4. And I think if they did have some of those pairs, they would have been able to get the HQ4 long
and
before
they,
now.
They upgrade to HQ4 indeed, but they are in sort of a dangerous spot here. Upgrading late, so there's always the opportunity of somebody for some reason having the cash to make an early majority buyout, so you gotta be cautious about that. However, I think it's fine for now.
Unfortunately, the only person who could make a majority buy right now is Ian, and Ian is also running behind in upgrades behind Fredward. Jimmy's very lucky that Fredward does not have the cash on hand to make the buy. Fredward is going into some late game items with the patent lab researching, carbon scrubbing. We do have multiple patent labs. Cold fusion, something came from an auction. But now we have
everybody's sitting on one patent labs. What are they all building? Or patenting?
Ian's not patenting anything, not going for teleportation. Status warp, patent lab not being used. I think it just finished being constructed. And the same with Jimmy. Jimmy's patent lab isn't even done being constructed yet.
So Ian is going for the teleportation that we requested in the early game, as expected. So he's hopefully gonna try and circumvent some shipping. However, he set himself up in a position where it doesn't really make too much of a difference, if I gotta be honest.
Yeah.
He doesn't have any remote production.
Just going to say that Ian has so much money that it might not be a bad idea to take out Dimmy.
Yeah, and this was what we touched on earlier. Dimmy lacking behind so much. There's always going to be this opportunity. However, Ian is now used most of his cash at upgrading to HQ5, which is a good long-term play. But then again, getting the buy on Dimmy is probably even the better long-term play, as he will have a higher stock price, will have a dividend revenue income long-term.
Yeah, so, it's one of those things that might not pay off, but I like being aggressive. I find that being aggressive, more often than not, does play out for you in the long run.
Yeah.
Dimmy, still very dangerous to being bought out. Same with Status Warp for majority buys, and both Ian and Fredward have lots of income that's coming on. Ian definitely benefiting from this really high life support prices, being able to teleport that, and then we're also moving into very remote chems.
Yeah, there we see the teleportation coming in with the remote production.
What Ian is going to really hope for is that chems stay high, because it's going to take so long to transfer or rotate these chems out should the price crash. So that's definitely a very big bet on Ian's part. And then what do you have? We have Optimization Center, Patent Lab, and Hacker Array all at the Colony.
That was just a long ship, so... But then again, there's no dynamites here, so... I guess it's not a terrible play.
Yeah, it's definitely
it's still quite a distance there.
Let's see... Wow.
I'm surprised we haven't seen Fredward or Ian getting aggressive here. They both is sitting on 100k with money in their own stock, maybe 140. Absolutely have enough to take out status here.
Yeah, well, I think what's going on is the two of them realize that the other is dangerous, right? And one thing I don't really like was this chemical hack that Ian just did. Ian just got his chems online. Fredward's been in multiple chems for a long time, and that's why Fred doesn't want to go in for majority buy. Fred's going for a hologram goon thinking machines off-world. 45k profit launches.
Yeah, that's untouchable almost right there. With the thinking machine, a goon, and everything, I mean... That thing is going to start making money for him in quite a bit as well.
Yeah, and I don't know that... I mean, spies are really cheap. If you're Ian, you need to be spying out all of this production that Fred has. And,
Ian is busy getting aggressive, though.
He is getting aggressive. I do like that. Unfortunately, it's a little bit too late, as Stasis is going to be able to defend themselves.
Yeah, at the point we were discussing it earlier, Stasis didn't have enough money to carry some stock. But when Ian actually got around to get aggressive, he did have 100k around and therefore is defended. And now Ian is in a situation where he ties up a lot of his money into the stock of Stasis, where he cannot finish the buy. So somebody like Fred Ward investing in offward trading companies or offward, what do you call them? Offward launchers or whatever?
Market.
Like he's going to have offward markets, apologies. He's going to have a better long-term advantage as he invested those money into making more money.
So, yeah. Well, Ian just needs to sell out of Status. Unfortunately, that was the wrong person to buy into when Ian was buying into Stasis. Dimmy had just upgraded and may have been able to get a majority buy there. Mm-hmm. That being said, Ian's still going into some decent patents, teleportation, slant drilling, virtual reality. They do have an optimization center that's coming online, but Fredward, two off-world markets. Chasing
it's going to be hard to stop now.
41k launches.
He's just going to pump these things out. He's going to secure his stock. He's going to stack up on money, and then he's going to get the buy on his biggest competitor, which here is Ian. And he's going to be hard to stop, really.
Now, that being said, Dimmy is in a place where, if I'm Dimmy, I'm going to try and make as much money as I can, sit out this fight, defend my stock, maybe start buying up into my stock right now. And maybe I can do something while Ian and Fredward fight each other, right?
Mm-hmm. Ian is making a lot of money, even though he's not enough for all. Then again, Fredward's self-worth haven't truly started paying off quite yet. And he's secured a lot of his stock, but I don't know, maybe Ian could get this buy sometime soon. He's halfway there at the moment, more or less. He's gonna have to acquire another 140k. Ooh, yeah, but there we go. Fredward getting aggressive. I like this play from him.
Yep, Ian is your biggest competitor. Ian's stock is undefended, so it won't cost the sticker price to purchase, while Ian has to pay double to take over Fredward's defended stock.
Ian is in trouble here.
Stasis Warp knows about Fredward's, one of Fredward's offworlds, but doesn't know about the other one. Dimmy, not necessarily know about either of them, and Ian doesn't necessarily know about either of them. While this glass is very far away, now fortunately it is a glass colony and limited silicon, which means Ian's glass right over here to the north of Fred is going to stay profitable throughout this game, so we won't have to rotate them, but yeah, Ian, in a little bit of trouble right now.
Still he does halfway... have slant drilling, yeah? Which allows him to do the last ones next
halfway to the buy on Stasis. Stasis is a scientist, is HQ5. If you could pick up that buy, you would be making good money off of Stasis very quickly.
But Fredward having two off-roads, though. Don't you think it's just going to delay the unavoidable? Buying out Stasis here.
I mean, Fredward is definitely in the driver's seat, and I'd say we're leaning towards this being Fredward's game to lose. Right? But if Ian is going to make a comeback and somehow win this game, it's going to be from finishing the buy on Stasis, because I think by now selling out of Stasis and switching to Fredward's probably a mistake. You're probably going to lose that race.
Yeah.
Trying to make himself more expensive, get more income than Fredward, and maybe do something. It's a risky strategy for sure, right?
It's a nasty MP, by the way. But yeah, the reason it's so risky, the reason you point this out, is because of the two off-world that's making so much money in Fredward's camp right there.
Mm-hmm.
Which puts him in such an awkward spot. If he buys out Stasis, it's dependent on him bringing him a lot of dividend revenue, and that pretty fast too, enough to catch up with Offworlds.
Well, now,
and here he tries to swap target, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, if he was going to swap targets, he should have done that as soon as Fredward started buying to him. Sell out of Stasis, buy your own stock, make Fred pay double to buy out some of your stock, because Ian's just spent so much more money than Fredward has on picking up Ian's stock. And you can see that reflected in the price, the cash on hand between Fredward and Ian, 100k difference.
success. Yeah, this is hard to find right here. But I don't know, was it really... I feel like if he's going to get the bio in stasis, it would be at the stage where Fred Edwards is approaching the bio on him. To just bump up his surprise and then give Fred Edwards even a bigger surprise when he eventually got to him. So it was in a hard spot, but as you said, maybe he should have done that a bit sooner. If he saw he couldn't take out stasis.
Yeah, I mean, Ian doesn't have any good options, I'd say, any right now. I definitely prefer to be Dimmy than Ian. Dimmy's got two off-worlds. Dimmy secured all their own stock.
Congratulations!
They just paid down into B debt. They do have some items that are not earning them any money, but they do have auto-off, so they're not losing the money. I would write Dimmy is in two optimization centers and is optimizing things. So they're setting themselves up to maybe try and be a spoiler between Fredward, and Fredward's only 10% of the buy. We'll have to see if that actually happens. Unfortunately for Dimmy, Fred's going to buy a scientist who's making money pretty quickly.
And Fred is going to have a nasty stock price after that buy is completed.
Mm-hmm. It's going to take Stasis and Dimmy working together to have a chance at taking out Fredward. And working together successfully is hard enough to do when there's good players playing together. And it's even harder when you have a bunch of new players playing together, right?
Absolutely. Now Ian being bought out, I want to point out maybe the biggest mistake that actually led to this, and that was the fact that when he bought into Stasis, didn't get the buy, he stayed in Stasis. You really don't want to do that, because you're setting yourself up as a big target when you can't get the buy. Then you'd rather sell out, invest them, and secure your own stock, and then you might see a situation where Ian and Fedwar are fighting on equal terms, both of them securing a lot of their stock, Ian producing more cash on Mars, and therefore possibly being able to fight out Fredward, or at least closer than what he was now.
Yep.
Don't you want to drop an EMP on Fredward's northern base here?
Yeah, I mean, it is 50k for EMPs. So Fredward is protected by that, but 50k.
So tempting, yeah.
still tempting. You're gonna have to make those investments if you're Dimmy and Stasis to have a chance at beating Fredward. Fredward already making 1,000 a second off of Ian, less than half a soul after they purchased Ian. So that money's gonna come in very fast.
Yeah, I don't see them completing the buy on Fredward. What's gonna happen here is that whoever of them who buys the most stocks from Fredward is going to buy out and get the stocks back.
Who caught a dirty rat trying to break our stock?
Right, unfortunately, they're not splitting it up right either. You need one person to buy the first half and the second person to buy the next half. But
even then, you run into the issue of Fredward buying out the guy who bought in all the stock before he could finish.
Right. Well, I'm painting the hypothetical scenario where they do win, right? What would have to happen?
Make room for the profits. Yeah, of course.
Not necessarily painting the realistic scenario, but the, you know.
I can agree to that.
That's case scenario. If it's going
to
work.
I've tried to instruct some people in random FFAQ to buy out all the stuff so I can try to finish. It's not too easy.
No, the late game stock market definitely very hard for new players to pick up, because while the AI in Offworld is pretty good compared to most RTSs, it doesn't know what it's doing in the late game, and you can usually beat it by then. The only way to practice late game is by playing against competent humans near to your skill set.
Absolutely.
And that's...
Look at that aluminium price, wow.
Yeah, Fred's playing around with prices, I think. Trying to hunt down and find Dimmy's off-worlds. Status warp is finally popping some goons somewhere.
But this game is essentially over though. Fred World with a massive dividend income from me inventing two Warlords. Almost got the buy on Dimmy right here. 85% through. And is with that going to get enough stocks in himself to sell out and get more or less the buy on stasis too?
Yep. Fred identifying that it was a glass colony, which meant the glass price was going to be high, correctly identifying that I can secure a good chunk of all the silicon on the map by founding as Nomad here, founded with what, the 38k debt, able to keep that debt in check by moving the two early geothermals on HQ3, and invested in some good patents, picking up thinking machines, carbon scrubbing, nanotech, and has just been able to roll over everybody.
Redwood really playing solidly. This will be his third victory out of three attempts in this this new Cuppers tournament right here. He seems to be in it for the long game, and he in every game here. He's like doing long term investments and boys doing late game even as a Nomad.
Yep, bought two claims, rabbit claims. So trying to even up the claim discrepancy between Fredward and the Expansive. Just giving that Nomad a little bit more late game staying power.
Absolutely. You can sell out of everything you got here. Stasis doesn't even have close to getting a potential majority buy here.
Yeah, so while we're waiting for this to finish up, let's just go. We touched on Ian, their major mistakes. Let's take a look. Let's talk about Dimmy. I did mention a little bit, you know, not going for those pairs for making money, which slowed down their upgrades. I think if they were able to keep pace with the upgrades with everybody else, they would have been in a much better position. Like you can see, like just looking at their base right now, they're making decent money. They have been making decent money. Once they got into HQ5, they just didn't rotate properly, didn't use adjacency bonuses, but they have, you know, they're not shipping, they're shipping a lot, but they're not shipping like too much. They have a good split between claims away from their base and claims next to their base as an expansive. You have those extra claims that you can work with.
I think what you pointed out was very accurate. It felt like they were always too late to the party. They got laid into the market because they got laid into the upgrades, and it all just boils down to the upgrades really, yeah? So when they eventually get into HQ5 and can start making those big money and invest in those off-roads, the other are already sitting on big stacks of cash, buying each other out, skyrocketing in price. So just a bit late. So if you would have been able to make more cash, as you say, avoiding these single tiles, black magic tiles, then maybe that could have helped him, catapulted him into a sooner upgrades.
Yeah, the good thing for Dimmy is Dimmy has like the right idea of what to do. It's just, you know, changing up like the mechanics of the execution. And that's mm-hmm. you know, easier to fix than if you're kind of floundering around and don't know what to do.
Yeah.
Then last, Stasis Warp, what do you think about them?
Stasis. That's a good question. I've got to think a bit about that. Why don't you tell me what you think?
So, I think you identified it when they found it and they put down these two remote steel mills. Scientists mm-hmm. need a lot of steel. Two is probably not going to cut it as a scientist. And being remote, it's hard to switch them out. When you need it, it delays your HQ1 upgrade a really long time because you wait for that steel to ship unless you're microing it in. And I think it just kind of expanded from there. Like, once again, Stasis in the same problem as Dimmy, not able to upgrade fast enough. So late into the markets, made decent money once they were in the markets, but, you know, just gotta keep pace. Now, as a scientist and expansives, you won't be keeping pace with a Nomad or a Scavenger. Those are the fastest two upgrades, but you know, they upgrade and then you upgrade, you know, a quarter of a soul or a half of a soul later. That's sort of keeping pace with them. And then you just, if somebody is running ahead as much as Fredward, you need to throw black market on them early. Unfortunately, this wasn't a great black market for slowing down a nomad. Just these EMPs. Once those EMPs got high, there weren't freezes, there weren't circuit overloads. Kind of hard to deal with that.
I gotta admit, I feel like there's not enough of a reason to find scientific where you found it. Generally, when you find scientific, you want a spot to really stand out as a fantastic scientific spot, because it's sort of a niche faction in a sense. And this spot not really having that niche element to it, and therefore it's kind of a okay but not fantastic. And then maybe you're better off trying to find a expansive spot, and you get more claims, and you can ship more effectively, or something that upgrades faster. So maybe that's a part of the issue too. But it's not terrible, but I feel like maybe it doesn't have enough. You see, he's running 4 glass kilns without having the bonus that you get with the scientific, where you can take it up from the ground, yeah? And remote shipping, as we pointed out.
Yep, just some little things to clean up. Unfortunately, Offworld is a game like StarCraft where you make little mistakes in the early game and they sort of, roll snowball out of control into the late game, and you got to be on point. It's very unforgiving in that way, just like other combat-based RTSs.
Yeah. I just can't help to think, what if he founded expansive on the exact same spot? Maybe that would have been better for him, actually.
Yeah, I would say that would have been much better.